Welcome to Word Problems. For our first set of word problems, we'll look at formulas that require certain orders of operations. Formulas, when you know them, can be very handy because they usually do have a set order of operations. Once you substitute your numbers in, as long as you do it correctly, you should have a very, very good idea where to go next at all times and have a clear through line to your answer. If we look at this first problem, as scary as it might look when you first see it, all it really consists of is substituting numbers in. In this case, the cost per unit is $15, therefore U is going to equal 15. It also says that the fixed costs, which is F, are 2,000. And finally, it says the total cost was 5,000. So the only thing that's actually missing here is N. And we can just substitute in everything else into that equation, which is T equals U times N plus F. Substituting all of these things in, I will get 5,000 is equal to 15 times n plus 2,000. And we can solve this like any other algebraic equation. I will just subtract 2,000. I then get 3,000 is equal to 15n. And then, of course, I divide both sides by 15. And if I do that, I get that n equals 200. So what this means, in real world speak, is that in order for these costs to have happened in this scenario, I would have to have produced 200 units. Our second problem is the same. It deals with simple interest, which works off of a simple equation. I equals PRT, where I is the amount of interest, it's the amount of new money. P is the principal, that's the starting amount. And then R is the simple interest rate, which we don't know yet. And then T is the time, which is always in years. So in this case, we know that the interest, we know that the amount of new money we got was $120. We started with 400. We don't know the interest rate yet, but we do know this has been going on for 2 years. And so now I can do the same thing. I can do 120. 400 times 2 is 800. So all of the right-hand side is really just 800R. And again, I can just divide by 800. If I do that correctly, I will get 0.15. Remember, to convert that to a percent, we move the decimal point 2 places to the right, and so this is equal to 15%. And that would be the rate of simple interest that gives you $120 in 2 years.